Hey guys, my name is Elena and welcome to or back to my channel. For today's video, I am going to just tell you guys what is in my makeup bags, like the ones that I just travel with if I go to like a family member's house for the weekend or just anywhere for the weekend. These are the products that I'll take with me. Now, some of these products do vary or change, like I switch out, so I'll probably have to do an updated one eventually in the future, but as of right now, this is what I always take with me. These are my favorite products that I regularly use. So first we're going to go into this bag because it has the least amount of stuff, and then I also have this bag that all my brushes are in and other tools. So this is the Morphe Babe bag. They still sell this. I believe it was only $10, so if you're interested in that. It has a plastic lining, so it's super easy to clean, which is what I like about it. And it's really big for only $10. It fits a lot in here, and I can still fit more. So the first thing I have is a setting spray, and this is the Gerard Cosmetics Slay All Day Setting Spray, and this is in the scent Dreamsicle. This is the Rich Luxe collaboration. This is my favorite one. It smells so good, and I'm telling you, this setting spray is like, I don't know, it's, this stuff keeps your makeup exactly where it is. Like, I can hug a million people and it will not transfer, so that's a really good setting spray. I also have the Morphe Continuous Mist, and I like this one, but it's not as good as the Slay All Day one. So the next thing I have is by Pierlise, and this is the Matcha Green Tea Antioxidant Priming Moisturizer. This stuff is amazing. It smells good. It feels good. I highly recommend you try this if you haven't already. I got it in an Ipsy Glam Bag Plus, I want to say. I don't remember how much it retails for, but I do think it's expensive because Pierlise is a pretty expensive brand. But I use this as a moisturizer even if I don't do my makeup, and it's good both ways, so love that stuff. And I'm running low, so I gotta get some more of it. The next thing I have here is foundation, and it's the regularly used one. This is by L'Oreal, and it's the Infallible Pro Matte 24 Hour Foundation. This is a really good one. It lasts all day on my face, I want to say. I work 10 hours a day. I have it on my face right now. I do my makeup pretty natural-ish, so you can't really tell when I have makeup on. But I'm trying to dabble in, like, you know, colors. So I do have, like, a ton of palettes. I just have to open up to using them more. But that's the main reason why I created, well, relaunched my channel as, like, a beauty channel, because I feel like it would help me open up more and try new things, and then even get better at like my makeup application. The next thing I have here is a highlighting palette, and this is by Jeffree Star Cosmetics. This is the Brain Freeze Skin Frost Pro Palette, and inside you have all of the shades. I'm not sure if you, I mean, you probably have seen this already, but these are really, really pigmented. These are like, I don't even have words because they're just so good. I use this palette every day. I use all of them except for this one because I didn't want to mess up the like detailing in there, so I haven't used that one. But I use all of the other ones. It just depends on what I'm wearing that day or how I'm feeling, but they're super pigmented. I'm not going to swatch them for you just because, I mean, you can go watch Jeffree Star's video when he launched this. I believe it was the Jawbreaker collection is when he launched this, so you can just go there, and or I'm sure you can find plenty of swatches on YouTube, so I'm not gonna take any of your time doing that. The next thing I have here is my Ride or Die face palette, and that's by CoverFX, and this is the Perfector face palette in light to medium. This is what it looks like here. So this we got in a BoxyCharm a couple months ago. I actually got the incorrect shade. I got the medium to dark one. If you are subscribed to BoxyCharm and you have been for a while, then you were around when that big issue happened with these. So I ended up giving that one away and buying this one myself. It was like $40-something, so it is pretty pricey. But I'm telling you, this brightening shade right here, let me see, like, that's what's in my inner corner right here, is this brightening shade is in my inner corner right here, and I also use it to highlight my brows, and it's pretty amazing. Like, I have to say, like, it's so good. When I first used that in the inner corner of my eyes, I was like blown away. It's just so good, like, so good. But I use that to bronze, I use it to highlight, all that stuff. The next thing that I have in here is something that always changes, and it's an eyeshadow palette. For right now, I have the Violet Voss Essentials, the Pro Series eyeshadow palette. This was also in a BoxyCharm. I've used it once, so you can see that it still looks brand new. I did do an eye look with it, but then I didn't have my mic on, so it was horrible. I didn't feel like doing a voiceover, so I'm just gonna have to recreate that look for you guys because I liked it. I posted the picture on my Instagram, so if you're interested in following me there, I'll link that down below. But this is a really good palette. Violet Voss has really, really good eyeshadows. I do have another palette by her, or by Violet Voss, and they're pretty good. They're very good eyeshadows. So my favorite shade in here is the emerald shade. That's the one that I used to create my look that I posted on Instagram. So, and last but not least, other than the Q-tips at the bottom of the bag that are not interesting, I use that to fix mascara mistakes. I have my Ride or Die setting powder, and that is the Coty Airspun. I know a lot of people don't like it because it has a fragrance that does linger, so be aware of that in case you want to try this. You smell it all day, so if you would have an issue with that, then I don't recommend you trying this if you're sensitive to fragrance, I guess. But for me, I love the smell, so it doesn't bother me at all. And it is like a white powder, so you do have to be careful with that also because of flashback, you know. But it's a really, really good setting powder. It does what it needs to do, and it's super affordable. I think it's like under $6. It's like five something, or it might be four something at Walmart or whatever drugstore you can find it at. But it's really worth it if you can get past the fragrance. So now we're gonna go into the next bag, and this is the Morphe and Jeffree Star brush bag when they did the first set of brushes. And I just keep all of my stuff in here, so we're just gonna go one by one in here. It's kind of disorganized because everything just kind of is like, there's no organization in here, so I'm working on a better solution. I did actually purchase the James Charles mini set because Ulta had the sale where you can get the bundle for like $59, which is the price of the brush set. So I was like, yeah, I might as well just do it because I really wanted the brushes more than the palette, but now I'm gonna get both, so I'm not really mad about that. So that'll help with my traveling with my brushes at least, and then I can throw all of the extra stuff into my makeup bag because you can still fit it. Enough babbling, let's get into this. So first thing I grabbed out of here, you already saw it. This is the brow gel. This is the 24-hour brow setter by Benefit. This is a really, really good brow gel. I mean, it does what it needs to do. Like, even if your eyebrows aren't done, you can, like, my eyebrow hairs are curly. I don't know, maybe you can see. Yeah, so like, even if my eyebrows aren't done, which they're not, if I use the glue, I can get these little hairs to like stay right there. And this is a really, really good gel. And if you've tried it, then you know, it's just, it does what it needs to do. The next thing I have is a razor. These are like the eyebrow razors. I always keep these with me because you never know when you need to like touch up your brows. I do my brows myself because I don't really ever have time to go get my eyebrows done. So I do them myself. And then also, I get like little black hairs under here. It's like a genetic thing. My mom always gets like one really long black hair right there. So I always, either I pluck it or I'll shave it. So that's what this is for. In case I don't have my tweezers, then I have this guy. I also have one in my car because you just, like I said, you never know. The next thing, this is like a life-changing mascara that I've spoke about a couple of times on my channel. This is by Thrive Cosmetics, and this is the Liquid Lash Extensions Mascara. This retails for $24. You can tell that I love this mascara because I know everything about it without even have to like look or think about it. This is the best mascara I've ever used in my life. Like, I was a Better Than Sex mascara user like religiously, and then I got this in an Ipsy Glam Bag Plus and it changed my life forever. This is the wand, so it's really thin, which is what I like because I can get all of my lashes like to stick together. I'm actually wearing this mascara right now. It's just a really, really good mascara. Like, I can't even explain it, but it's because of the wand being so thin, you can get all of your lashes without like touching the lid of your eye and messing it up and then having to use a Q-tip to clean it up. You can also use it for your bottom lashes because it's so thin, unlike these type of mascaras that have like these really fluffy wands. It's a little more difficult to get your bottom lashes. This is a really good mascara too. This is the Big Ego by Tarte. I like this one. I love the packaging because it's so bright and pink, but again, nothing that I've tried so far beats this mascara, so... And I've tried a couple mascaras. I've tried a lot of mascaras, and this one is by far the best. Now I'm going to talk about brushes because I just want to get those out of here. So I have the Juvia's Place foundation brush. It's angled. This is my favorite brush to apply foundation with because of the fact that it's angled, it just makes it so much easier to, like... I don't know how to explain it, to like just mix it in. There's a different word. It's also good for powder because of the fact that it's angled. You can like dip into your powder, loose powder, and like set under your eyes like so easily. And then this is an all-purpose brush. I freaking love it. Now, I think this is like a $20 brush also, but Juvia's Place always, always, always has sales. And if you use an influencer's code like Fumi, F-U-M-I, love her so much, you can get even more money off. Like, I have so many Juvia's Place palettes. I need to start doing videos on them because I haven't got to use many of them, and that's a perfect excuse to get to use them. The next brush I have is by SL Miss Glam. I used to say Slimmest Glam until I looked it up to buy some of these brushes, which are very expensive, and then I found out that it's actually SL Miss Glam, but I'm still going to be saying Slimmest Glam because it's just easier for me. But this is the L36. I got this in Ipsy like years ago. I use this for highlight, so it has like a lot of glitter specks inside. But I use this for highlight because it's so easy. I guess it still has some highlight on it, but I haven't washed my face yet anyway. But I like this brush for highlighter. I'm the type of person that I use my brushes for whatever I feel like using them for, whatever it works for me. I don't use them how, like, the brush is supposed to be used for. They're your brushes. You can use them with what fits you. The next brush is a foundation brush, and this is by Morphe. This is the M439. This was my very first ever foundation brush, because I used to only use beauty blenders, and then I bought this brush because of Jaclyn Hill. Like, years ago she swore by this brush for foundation, and I've followed her since, like, you know, pre-fillers. So I was like, I gotta try this brush because I love Jaclyn Hill and I trust her. So I got it, and I love this brush. It's a really, really good brush. It's one of my favorite foundation brushes. I might have to do a video on my top favorite foundation brushes so I can show you them, do a little video on them, and that jazz, whatever. Let's move on. The next brush we have is also by Morphe. I love Morphe's brushes. Like, I just think that for the price, they are really good quality. I've never had any issues with Morphe brushes. Like, I don't know why people hate on Morphe so much, because their brushes are good. I mean, if you want like super high quality brushes, then you need to go to like Sigma. Because I have a little sample down there. Sigma brushes. But anyway, this is the Morphe E4, and I use this to bronze. It's angled, so I just bronze up here, contour, all that. It's a really soft brush, and I love the handle. It's like shiny, but it has some weight to it, and it feels high quality, even though it's, you know, it's like drugstore pricing, I guess. So the next thing we have here is the lip product. I was going to go to the brushes, but I'll leave the eye brushes for later. This is a sugar lip scrub. It's an all-natural lip scrub by Beauty Treats, and this is a mango one. This is a really good lip scrub. I got this at a beauty pop-up shop here in Deltona, Florida, so I don't know if you can purchase this. Like, I'm going to look it up, Beauty Trends, and see if you can. It's individually owned by a woman, so she's supposed to come back next month, and I want to go again because I want to support woman-owned businesses, especially makeup. I mean, come on. And I think, if I can remember, I want to vlog it. Like, I want to bring you guys along so you can see what a makeup pop-up shop is in case you have never been to one or you've never even heard of it. Because it was just so cool. It was so cool. I dropped my brush. I'm going back to the brushes. We don't have that much stuff left though. The next thing I have here is by Juvia's Place also. This is the eyeliner brush. So this comes in the eyeliner duo that you would get off of their website. This is a really, really good eyeliner brush. It's like really soft. I mean, there's not really much I can say about an eyeliner brush, but it's a really good one. In the set, you get a black and you get a brown, and they're like the best like gel eyeliners I've ever used. They go on like super smooth, and you don't have to like keep going back to like fill it in. It's opaque. That's the word. Brushes. So we have the Morphe and Jeffree Star JS7. This is the eyebrow brush. Sorry that it's not focusing. It just wants to focus on my face. But I use this just to like brush my brow hairs first, and then I use my brow product. This is the Billion Dollar Brows Microblade Effect Brow Pencil in the shade Dark. This is what I use to fill in my brows right now, because I used to use the Chocolate Brownie by Too Faced and I completely ran out. Eye brushes. So this is by Moda Pro, and it's Royal and Lagnicle, I believe. And yeah, Royal and Lagnicle, but it's the Moda Pro line. And I have, it's a set. This is a brush set. There's only one brush missing. I have it put away somewhere because I wouldn't use it. I can't remember what brush it was, but I got this in a BoxyCharm. So we have the crease brush. We have the crease brush here. Detail brush. This is the brush that I use to put my inner corner highlights on because it's like a pencil brush, so it's just perfect for that. The next one is the smudger brush. It's a flat brush, so it's good for doing your like tight line or like lining your under eye. And then last but not least is the shader brush. So this is just a flat like packing brush. Alright, so my memory card decided that it wanted to be full, so let's carry on. So we have the Morphe Vitamin C Gel Liner. This is the shade. This is a really, really good eyeliner. The only thing is that you do have to, like, once you put it on, you do have to go back over it because it's not as opaque as I would like it to be, but that's not a problem. I don't mind, because you could just put down your first line, let it dry a little bit, go back over it, and then bam, you're good. Now, as for the Juvia's Place eyeliner, you can do one line and you're good. Like, that's how opaque this eyeliner is. It's a little dried out as of right now, but it still works pretty good. Like, it just looks dry, but when you go to use it, it's actually not. I just need to get some, like, vitamin E drops, and I can pop one of those in there, and it's brand new. The next thing I have in here is actually an eye balm, and this is the Moisturizing Eye Balm by Belief. I got this in an Ipsy bag. I use this to like moisturize my eyes before I put anything on them. The next thing I have in here are shadow shields. I use this to do my winged liner because I cannot do winged liner to save my life by myself. So I have to have guidelines. And I also use this so that I get that like cut type of look with my eyeshadow because that's just what I like. But I got a pack of like 100 or 200 of these on Amazon for really, really cheap. The next thing we have is an eyeliner pen, and this is my ride or die eyeliner pen. Like, I swear by it. This is the only eyeliner pen I need in my life. And this is by Hank and Henry, and it is the Slick With It Blickety Black Long Wear Liquid Eyeliner. Here it is right here. So we also got this in a BoxyCharm. And it's like the best thing that I've ever gotten in a BoxyCharm, I think, because it's just so good. I've even used it to like do face paints, like a skull, and it's just good, guys. It's just good. And then last but not least, we have two items left. We have a lip liner by Rimmel London, and this is in the shade 032 Innocent. So it's just a nude eyeliner pencil. Nothing special about that. It's actually the same color as my lips, so you can't even really see it when you put it on. It's really just a guideline for me. And then I have a nude lipstick, and this is the Pro Matte Liquid Lipstick Infallible by L'Oreal, and it's the Les Macaroons line, and this is in the shade Mom Caramel 822. This is a really, really good line of lipsticks. Like, I love them. I feel like I'm saying that a lot, but like I said in the beginning of this video, these are my favorite items, so I'm gonna say I love all of them because I just do. Now, that's everything when it comes to, like, makeup products, because I do have a separate bag of, like, skincare products that I, like, obviously take with me for, like, my face, because I don't really break out. Thank you, Lord, I don't. But I take care of my skin, that's why. So I wash my face, and then I exfoliate. Not every day, I exfoliate, like, every 2 to 3 days. And then I, you know, tone my face, moisturize, and all that jazz. So I make sure that I take care of my skin, because, like we all know, makeup enhances what is already there. So if you have bad skin, it's just gonna enhance your bad skin, unfortunately. But if you just get a really good skincare routine down, then you'll be set. That being said, I'm gonna leave you guys on that, and thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you like it and you subscribe so that you can see more from me, because more is coming, I promise you. I will see you next time. Bye. I tried it once before, but I didn't get too far. I felt a lot of pain, but it didn't stop my heart.